Bonjour everyone, Pentouf here today for a new video concerning both World of Tanks Blitz and also Tank Company, the brand new, that is not out yet, but the brand new competitor to World of Tanks Blitz. And in this video, we're gonna take a look at something Tank Company did that, let's say, made me laugh quite a bit. What you're looking at right now will seem quite similar to what we have in World of Tanks Blitz currently, aka the gravity mode. Because if you look closely, all the tanks are flying around and going extremely fast. I knew already, and a lot of people told me, that Tank Company was kind of a copy paste of World of Tanks Blitz on some specs, but I would have hoped that at least Tank Company will find something else than already used game modes like Gravity. I'm not blaming Tank Company for doing that because I kind of don't care from a customer perspective. I think it's funny. But seriously, guys, you could have at least renamed the mode to something else than Gravity game mode like we have in World of Tanks Blitz. But anyway, that's their choice. I guess it's either marketing or they wanted to disrespect Wargaming on that. And I gotta be fair, I find it quite funny that they did this. But anyway, let's talk a little bit about Tank Company. You already know that game in the channel, or on the channel, I should say, because we talked about it quite a lot, at least in two or three videos. It's the main competitor of World of Tanks Blitz that should hit Android phones in less than 6 months, if I'm not mistaken, because they are planning to do a release worldwide. It's a Chinese game for the moment, and it's gonna keep it that way, I guess. And let's be fair, its main advantage over World of Tanks Blitz is probably the 15 versus 15 game mode, but also the graphics that look much better. It looks more than World of Tanks Blitz. It looks like World of Tanks PC, in my opinion, which is gonna make it hard, I think, to play it on older device. But that's it for the moment. And obviously, as it's a tank game, they wanted to make it attractive to new players. And for the beta that they run, the beta, like, if I'm not mistaken, 1 month ago, or maybe a little bit less, at the beginning of April. And in order to test every single specs of the game, they decided, you know what, let's create game modes, let's allow player to get quite a lot of different tanks, etc, etc, for us to have a really good and general feedback on what's the game looking like right now. And that's why maybe they went for those game modes. But seriously, Gravity game mode, they also have the 7 versus 7 game mode, because they did not only steal, or at least I suppose that they did, maybe they didn't and they came up with the idea, even if I would be quite surprised if it was their own idea and not a copy paste from World of Tanks Blitz. I gotta defend World of Tanks Blitz on this time, because seriously, here it looks obvious that they took it from there. And so I was saying, they tested quite a lot of game modes. There was Gravity, there was the 5 versus 5, 7 versus 7 as well. And obviously the 7 versus 7 format is on smaller maps, which looks even more than World of Tanks Blitz, because here all the maps are quite huge. Take a look at the Gravity map. It looks like it's 15 kilometers wide on every single square. And this is what makes it hilarious, in my opinion, because even if this tank game seems quite attractive at first, and I'm sure it will, no problem, no doubt, and obviously when it's gonna be released, I'll do videos on this one. I will not stop World of Tanks Blitz, don't worry, but I would like to try out that game as well, because it seems quite interesting, as they have wheel tanks like the AMX-10 RC you're taking a look at right now. But yeah, what I was saying here is that they are copy-pasting quite a lot. For the best or for the worst, we'll have to see. But I would like to get you guys, your feedbacks concerning that game. Will you play it? I think most of you will. Oh, nice. They already have. I didn't know that they had this. Oh, and they also have those physics allowing you to just turn around like that. Your tank. Ooh, okay. They have a big advance on World of Tanks Blitz, gotta be fair. At least on graphics and on mechanisms like that. But don't worry, it will come soon in World of Tanks Blitz. If it's released in World of Tanks, in Tank Company, it's gonna be released in World of Tanks Blitz, because they will have to do it. They'll not have the choice. World of Tanks Blitz will have to adapt to keep their customers, and that's the main thing about Tank Company, and that's why I'm excited about them releasing Tank Company, not necessarily for the game itself, but for the things Wargaming will have to improve for us to get a game that is potentially better. Let's be honest, it's the exact same thing. But even if Tank Company looks better graphically, when you compare both the games, like on a straight line in 8 minutes, when you switch to World of Tank Blitz or to Tank Company from World of Tank Blitz in less than 5 seconds, even if it seems like graphically talking Tank Company is a better game, I still find World of Tank Blitz quite a beautiful game, gotta be fair. I don't think that this game is ugly, and I think it's truly remarkable how Wargaming is working with their graphics to make the game look better than it is. What I mean by that is, when you take a look at Yukon, for example, the map we're playing on right now, the colors that are kind of saturated makes the game looks better. It's not the case, obviously, but from the human eye perspective, it looks like it. And that's all we're asking Wargaming. We don't necessarily need better graphics. We need them to make us think that there are better graphics. And that's exactly what they're doing with those new maps that are well worked, with quite a lot of details, quite a lot of colors. Let's say that the palette of colors is so wide that it really makes you feel like, yeah, the game is still good graphically talking. I know a lot of people are complaining about the graphics in World of Tank Blitz. It happens quite a lot, like, well, where are the new graphics? The game looks ugly. You know why? Because people tend to compare World of Tank Blitz with World of Tank PC. Why would you do that, guys? Why? It's not the same. This is a mobile game. We're talking about something you have to play from a phone, and from a cheap phone, because not everybody owns an iPhone 12 or an iPad last generation Pro, etc, etc. So yeah, Wargaming has to compromise for us to get good graphics, while at the same time allowing the maximum player base to be able to play. And to be fair, I think they do quite a good job. Now, if they could remove the pay-to-win aspects and crates, that would be even better, but that's a subject for another video. But anyway, when we take a look at Tank Company, it looks exactly like the game mode we have here, so maybe they are taking some aspects of World of Tank Blitz. But if it's the case, I'm curious to see if Tank Company will really be released on the European market, because if Wargaming feels a complaint to the European court, I think they could win, because here it's kind of obvious that they copy-pasted some ideas from World of Tank Blitz. But we will see what the court said if they ever go there. And I'm gonna leave you here, guys, because I think that I've talked about everything I had to. Hopefully you enjoyed. If you did, feel free to subscribe, like, and share, and I'm gonna see you soon for a new video. Bye.